Children, let's begin with the fourth revision, that is the beggar. Okay, I'm going to start again with the summary only, so I just want you to listen carefully to the summary. The summary is the beggar, you know, is the story about a beggar named Lushkov. You remember I taught you Lushkov? Yes. So while begging, who did he meet? He met an advocate, right? And who's the advocate? What was his name? His name is Sergei, right? And what did Sergei do? Sergei gave him work. And Sergei, what was the work that was given to Lushkov, the beggar? Yeah, Sergei asked him to cut wood at his house, isn't it? And he asked his cook to show him the shed where the wood was kept. So the beggar was too weak and was under the influence of alcohol too. He was an drunkard, isn't it? I taught you. Yes. And he was barely stand on his feet. That much he used to drink. And still, you know, the cook, Olga, you know who the cook is? Olga is the cook. Olga told Sergei that the wood had been chopped. Okay, Sergei was glad that the man worked and paid him how much? First, he paid him 50 kopecks for doing what? For chopping the wood. And he asked him to come on the first day of every month for it. Sometimes he would ask to shovel the snow or set the wood in the shed, okay? Or to dust the rugs. All this work was given by whom? By Sergei, right? You remember? He would pay about how much? 20 to 40 kopecks. And once, what did he do? He gave him an old trousers also, isn't it? Okay, when Sergei shifted his house, what did he do? He called the beggar for help for transporting the articles. The beggar had changed as he was sober that day, and Sergei felt very satisfied that his efforts had paid in reforming a drunkard. Yes, so he thought because Sergei spoke to the beggar, whatever efforts he put, okay, on the beggar has reformed the beggar from being a drunkard. Yes, so he could read and write also. Sergei asked his name. As he could read and write, Sergei asked his name. He offered him a better job. He shook hands with him. And after that day, Lushkov, the beggar, was never seen. Yes or no? Yeah. So he went away. You know, a letter was given to him. He asked him to go and meet his friend. All that you remember, right? Okay. After 2 years, what happened? Sergei was buying a ticket outside a theater and spotted Lushkov. Lushkov was very well dressed and was buying a ticket of the gallery area. Okay. And then Sergei was glad to see him. He called him. He recognized Lushkov. So Lushkov also recognizes Sergei. And Lushkov was now working as what? He was working as a notary. And he earned how many rubles? He earned around 35 rubles a month. And he thanked Sergei for helping him out of the pit. What was the pit he was in? He was a beggar, right? So he thanked him for his kindness. Lushkov told Sergei that it was not for him, but for his cook, Olga, that he was a changed man. See, though Sergei helped him, he says, of course, sir, you helped me, but who actually changed me, who actually reformed me is the cook, Olga, isn't it? She would scold him, cry for him, chopped all the wood for him, it seems. And her behavior actually transformed Lushkov. With this, he went to the theater. So this is the summary of the lesson that I've given you, children. Let's go on to the question and answers. Okay? Yes. And next comes, these are all the textual questions that I've given you. The questions and the answers, that is, has Lushkov become a beggar by circumstance or by choice? How did he become? He became by circumstance or by choice? Yalashkov became a beggar due to his circumstances only, not by choice. Okay? And the answers continue. The next one is, is Lashkov a willing worker? Why then does he agree to chop wood for Sergei? Is he willing? He was not fit actually, but still, because he wanted to get rid of his alcohol consumption, he tried to do what? He tried to do something, some job he needs, isn't it? Okay, all these are textual questions that I've given you. The third one is, what reasons does he give to Sergei for his telling lies? And then Sergei says, I am happy that my words have taken effect. Why does he say so? Is he right in saying this? Yeah. So you just have to read it and write the answers. Next comes, Lashkov is earning 35 rubles a month. How is he obliged to Sergei for this? Yeah. How? When Sergei saw that Lashkov had given up to drinking, he offered him a better job, due to which Lashkov became a notary one day. Right? That's how he could earn around 35 rubles a month. Okay. The next one is, during their conversation, Lashkov reveals that Sergei's cook Olga is responsible for the positive change in him. How has Olga changed or saved Lashkov, you think? Yeah, she chopped wood, she gave him all the advice, isn't it? Yeah. Now comes the long answer, which is in the book. That is, how can we help beggars abolish begging? This is actually an answer that has to be written on your own, but still I've given you the answer. You just can go through it. Next comes the extra questions. We're going to see to the extra questions. The first one is, how did Sergei recognize the beggar? How did he recognize? Yeah, his face appeared familiar to him. He tried to recollect where he had seen him. Suddenly his eyes fell on the beggar's shoes. One was low, one was high. Isn't it? Okay, and then he clearly remembered where he had seen the beggar before. Right? What kind of work was given to Lashkov children initially? Why did he agree to do it? Yeah, Sergei refused to give alms to him. Alms means what? Help to him as a beggar. So he offered him a job. He took him home, gave him work of chopping wood, and then Lashkov agreed to do this work. Not because he was hungry, but he needed some work. So he agreed to do it because of pride and shame. And because he had been trapped by his own words, he had to accept this. Okay, next, third one is, how did Olga treat Lashkov in the beginning? Why did she do this? You know how she treated him. Carelessly, isn't it? And she called him a drunkard. She used to abuse, scold him so badly. She rebuked him. Yes, and then she would sit before him and grow sad. She used to cry, she wept in front of him. And then she chopped wood for him. She did this because she felt pity for him. Yes. And then fourth one, where did Sergei see Lashkov after 2 years? What work was he doing then? Where did he see him? He saw him at the ticket window of a theater. Yes. And then what was his job now? Now he was very well dressed, isn't it? And what was the job that he was doing? He was a notary. And how much was he paid? He was paid 35 rubles a month, isn't it? Yes. Now let's write a brief character sketch of Olga. Olga is a nice lady, right? She was very kind. Though she rebuked him, you know, she loved Lashkov. She felt very pity for him. And she did the chopping work for him. Olga's kindness was really great, and it had a great effect on whom? On Lashkov. That's what he says. It is not Sergei. Sir, you may have brought me to your house, but actually who reformed him was Olga. Yes. Okay. What did Sergei offer the beggar? Why? Sergei asked Lashkov to work instead of begging. He gave him what? Chopping of wood, earn money, and then he believed that people could be reformed by hard work and not by giving sympathy or alms. Yes or no? Yes. Then what remuneration was paid to Lashkov for chopping wood for the first time? What do you mean by remuneration? Remuneration is the salary, the amount that was paid. How much was it was paid for him initially? Yeah, yes, yes. So 50 kopecks, and then later he earned, once he went to, what is that, to be a notary, he was given 35 rubles. Yes. And then next is, how did Sergei help Lashkov to live respectfully? How? He thought giving him this odd jobs will not work. Chopping of wood is not going to be, it is not going to be liked by Lashkov, he knows. So what did he do? He sent him to his friend with a letter of recommendation for a cleaner employment as a copier. That is, as a, later he became, as actually he went as a person to copy. As a copier he went, but later he became a notary. Yes. Then comes, who was Lashkov? Give the credit for reforming him. Why? Who was Lashkov? You know, he was a beggar. Lashkov is grateful to Sergei for employment, but he gives true credit for his reformation to whom? To Olga. He says that Olga is the one who changed him. Outwardly, she was full of anger and spite. She was full of anger. She was full of hatredness from inside. But her heart was full of human sympathy and kindness. She was severely scolding him for being a drunkard. But she wept for him and she chopped wood for him. Isn't it? Yes. Now comes the long answer type. Describe the first meeting between Sergei and Lashkov children. First meeting, where did they meet? He met him on the road. He was dressed in very poor clothes. He was crying and requested Sergei to have pity on him. He told Sergei that he had to offer, he had the offer of a position in Kaluga, it seems. All these lies he told, remember? But he did not have money to get there. So he wanted some money to pay for the fare. Sergei looked at the beggar closely. Suddenly he remembered that he had seen him the previous day in Sadovya Street. That's how they met. First it was like a meeting of conflict. But then later what happened? Later he was offered a job. And then all these lies, he says that he was expelled from, as a student, he was expelled from the job. All this he told him, but Sergei came to know it was all lies. And then what did he do? He refused to give him help, but what did he do? He took him home and asked him to chop wood. Yes. Now comes the second one, that is, Sergei's sympathy was as important as Olga's noble deeds that reformed Lashkov. Discuss. Is it the same thing what we discussed? Whether Sergei played a very important role or Olga played a very important role in Lashkov's life. So that is what the answer is given. That is, Lashkov gave the credit of his reformation to Olga, but it is true that Sergei's sympathy towards him was also important. Of course, if Sergei had not brought him home, he wouldn't have seen Olga, isn't it? If Sergei had not taken the initiative to assign work to Lashkov and had instead handed him over to the police, the beggar's life would have ended in a disaster. Yes or no? Yes. Sergei, like Olga, went out of his way to uplift the ragged beggar by making him do odd jobs and paying him in return. Sergei was not obliged in any way to spend money on a beggar in this manner, but it was his concern for Lashkov that he made sincere efforts to reform him. See, he was also a very good man. He tried to reform him in many ways. He brought him, he gave him trousers, he gave him a job, and then he gave him a recommendation letter. All this was done by whom? By Sergei only. And again it was Olga's job also that she spoke to him so much and she also changed him. So both of them have equal role in reforming the beggar. Isn't it, children? Yes, I think I have done with it. So you can write, copy down all the answers, whatever has been given. Okay, thank you very much.